Oh, hi, I'm the Heretic. I'm going to be part of a podcast talking about the stuff uncovered related to communist YouTubers like Batco, Democratic Socialist 01, Thought Slime, An Actual Joke, Finnish Bolshevik, and others. Specifically, uncovering evidence that they participated in even run servers to mass flag people's channels and to dox people, in addition to pedophilia. Kraut and T was shamed off the internet for less than 1/10 of how much we got. Literally gigabytes of screenshots and audio recordings. The podcast will be hosted on Operation Bluism's channel. He's the mastermind behind all this, and a big chunk of the credit goes to him. He's a voluntarist communist. Now, I know what you're thinking, but trust me, he's one of the good guys. Subscribe. Link in the description. Anyways, on to the real video. So there's a lot to talk about. Trump's new Space Force, which is off to a rocky start after they were griefed by an EVE Online player with a $3,000 spaceship. Definitely not fake news. There was also a manufactured controversy by collectivists pretending to be outraged about Bush and Obama-era policies of placing minors in care facilities while their alleged parents are being processed through Immigration and Customs. If they really cared about children, they would demand the welfare state be immediately and permanently closed for business, so there's no incentive for parents to send their children traveling miles through one of the most dangerous places on Earth. If they cared about kids, they would repeal no-fault divorce laws. They would shut down government schooling, disincentivize and stigmatize single motherhood, and end the wholesale slaughter of children through abortion. Yeah, they don't care about kids. But something that slipped under the radar is the Supreme Court, in a 5-4 decision, allowed states to impose sales taxes on online purchases. States can now require online retailers by force to collect sales tax, if the state so chooses. This decision will be known as South Dakota vs. Wayfair Inc. This was upholding a 2016 South Dakota law requiring online retailers to collect state sales tax if they sold $10,000 in South Dakota or had more than 200 transactions. This overturns a previous ruling in Quill Corporation versus North Dakota in 1992, where the court argued that as long as an online retailer didn't have a physical presence in the state, they can't compel them to collect sales tax. No physical presence being defined as owning no real estate or hiring employees in said state. Now here's a question, how did the market reply? Wayfair stocks dropped 9.4%. 1-800-Flowers dropped 1.3%, Chegg dropped 7.8%, Amazon lost 1.9%, Etsy fell 5.7%, and eBay fell 12.6%. Meanwhile, Avalara, who make tax processing software, saw their stocks rise 11.9% in the wake of this multi-billion dollar blow to digital retailers. Brick-and-mortar stores, which had previously been on the decline, saw modest stock rises. Walmart gained 1.1% in stock value. Best Buy gained 2.5%. So this is clearly a big win for traditional retailers. This, in the era of dinosaur retailers falling left and right to their digital competitors. Toys R Us and Sports Authority being two casualties of society's inexorable transition into the new digital age. Digital retailers had the advantage that they weren't required to pay sales taxes under the previously mentioned Quill Corp vs. North Dakota 1992 decision. Like everything the state does to restrict free enterprise, it will stifle competition. For startups, this is a tremendous problem. You can see the chilling effect this would have on revenue if what they're selling is suddenly 5% more expensive. Price goes up, demand goes down. It's simple supply and demand. States could pass holy commandments requiring e-commerce sites to pay sales taxes whenever anyone in such a state buys a product. Do you honestly think small online retailers will be able to remain in compliance with dozens, even hundreds, of tax-collecting agencies across all these jurisdictions? Of course not. With massive barriers to entry and being forced to compete with budget retail giants with gigantic government-granted advantages, this law further cements their soft monopoly, allowing places like Amazon or Walmart to screw over their employees. You think Amazon won't be able to comply with this tax law? Of course they will. In fact, they already pay sales taxes in many states on first-party sales. If this is what Trump meant when he said that this was a victory for fairness, then mission accomplished, asshole. But why are they doing this? It's hard to ascribe motives to the Supreme Court beyond pure ideology. The Constitution? I mean, yes, under the 10th Amendment, the states implementing sales tax is constitutional, but let's be honest, when was the last time the Supreme Court gave a damn about the US Constitution? But the Supreme Court can't just make rulings unless someone brings a case before them. So why did the state of South Dakota bring this up? The Supreme Court syllabus can be pretty revelatory. South Dakota's motivation for passing the law in dispute and filing the suit was an eroding tax base. Yeah, they weren't stealing enough of their people's money. It's to pay for infrastructure, you see. Critical infrastructure. No, really. What is it? It can't be pensions because South Dakota's pension program is roughly 90% funded, which, relative to the rest of the US, is actually pretty good. The syllabus mentions the argument that the 1992 ruling cost the state of South Dakota $48 to $58 million annually. So it is about money. There are people who don't physically exist in your state, but they have to pay taxes to you anyways. Now, Trump said that this is a win for fairness. Let me tell you something about fairness. Fairness isn't needing to know the tax laws in all 50 states because a customer might buy something from those states. Fairness isn't stealing from your people from the point of a gun to pay for things you know they don't want. And you know they don't want it because you're using taxes to pay for them. If you're really concerned about fairness between online retailers and brick-and-mortar stores, then you'd make all sales taxes illegal forever. All this means is that we have fewer ways to keep our money out of the hands of our overpensioned, bloated, bureaucratic, borderline dictatorial priesthood of statism. This comes hot on the heels of the EU Digital Common Market and its Article 13 bit on internet censorship machines getting passed through committee. Suffice to say, things aren't looking too positive for the moment. Financially, South Dakota isn't in the worst shape, like I said, but Michigan, New Jersey, California? You're damn right they'll do anything to continue the wealth transfer from struggling millennials to old economy Steve in the form of public sector pensions and Medicare. You don't think the federal government might try to get in on the gravy train too one of these days? Of course they will. Especially given that Social Security liability is now over $17 trillion. Now, maybe nothing will happen. It'll be years before some states implement internet sales taxes. Maybe. But all this appears too much like a deliberate attack on your ability to access the deconstruction of propaganda in real time through the internet. All the reason more why we need the expansion of blockchain technology and the rise of cryptocurrency. That's the logical response to states, municipalities, and federal governments passing their own internet sales taxes. It's the only way struggling millennials can keep their standard of living intact and not subsidize the freaking baby boomers. Oh, and the whole Amazon launching cloud computing for the government to spy on us and store our private information on the same day as the Supreme Court ruling? Yeah, let's just ignore that. Questions, comments, critique? Is there something I'm overlooking here? How do you feel about your disposable income being suddenly reduced by up to 7%? Support me through a one-time donation on Ko-Fi or subscribing through Patreon. Like, share, and subscribe to become a heretic today.